All right, no recording. Sounds about right. I need a new hard drive. But we get right into this game. Power Friendship up against the Dunlap Eagles in this best of two high school star league. I would guess it's technically the spring season of 2017. We take a look at these bans from both sides. Power Friendship, they're going to ban out the Lifestealer, Drow, and Lashrak. Follow that up with the Huskar Dunlap Eagles. They've banned out the Ember Spirit, the Slardar Axe, and Sniper. So we get on into these picks. Power Friendship, they've gone with the Ogre Magi and Underlord. And for the side of Dunlap Eagles, they've gone Lone Druid, aka the better Sniper, and Dazzle and Juggernaut. So Underlord right now for Power Friendship, looking to be in that offlane. Ogre Magi going to be a support for the side of Power Friendship. Dunlap Eagles, they've picked up the Lone Druid, who's probably going to be in the mid lane. And then Juggernaut, who is going to be in that safe lane, and they follow that up with a Lich. So Lich, Dazzle, the two supports on Dunlap Eagles. Power Friendship, they go with the Weaver, and after picking up that Disruptor, this is a safe lane Weaver, not a support Weaver, which we have seen in a little bit more higher up competitive play. But Disruptor, Ogre Magi, Underlord, Weaver, a solid combination. Ogre Magi, of course, he's going to be there with his mid hero, giving Bloodlust and just trying to make moves towards that mid lane. Dazzle, Lich, going to probably be tri-laning with Juggernaut. So Power Friendship, they're looking at a Weaver up top. Ogre Magi kind of sitting mid with a Disruptor up there with Weaver. Underlord, he can take care of himself in the offlane. And maybe we even see a little bit of a swap where Weaver goes into the offlane and Underlord up into that safe lane. Weaver, Disruptor, offlane, try and get more farm for that Weaver, but it's really up to how Power Friendships, how they feel comfortable. So last ban comes out from Dunlap, they're going to ban out this Tinker, and we'll see what Power Friendship are going to ban out. It's going to be a Marana. Not too sure why you ban out a Marana. Juggernaut safe, Lone Druid mid, Marana not really an offlaner. But maybe that's just what you don't want to be up against, and that's always fine. So, Invoker going to be mid, and maybe now Invoker mid, you don't really need that Ogre Magi coming over. Invoker can kind of handle himself, as long as he doesn't get rooted by the bear or anything too crazy. Of course, there is the Poison Touch from Dazzle that can come over and slow the Invoker if they do want to make a gank, as well as the Frostblast here. So, we'll have to see what Dunlap Eagles are going to do. It looks as though it's just going to be a Lich, Dazzle, Jug, Tri-Lane, Power Friendship. They've got the Invoker, Weaver, Underlord cores with the Disruptor, Ogre Magi supports. And last pick for the side of Dunlap Eagles is going to be that Necrophos. So, Necro coming into the game, it's an interesting pick. Could see him go in the offlane, but usually safe lane Necro is kind of where it's been played recently. Yeah, turn that off. Alright, we're back, we're ready, I think. Game's frozen. Prepare for battle. There we go. So we get a quick pause already from Zaturk. On the side of Power of Friendship, on this Invoker, it is going to be Zaturk. It's going to be Conkle on the Disruptor, and then Destiny 99 on the Ogre Magi, Smacks on the Weaver, and then finally Gigan on the Underlord for the side of Power of Friendship. We take a look at the other side. This is going to be Dunlap, Kyuku on the Lich. Dazzle is going to be played by Ascendant. Zero on the Lone Druid. Pingu playing the Necrophos. And finally on the Juggernaut is going to be Pi. So we've got this pause. We'll have just a moment until we're ready to go. And when we get ready and when we're on our way, hopefully we'll see some action. So we get the unpause from Pingu. We're ready to go. Got a minute till the horn, a minute till the bounty runes. We'll try to see this lane out. Smacks, he's looking to set up top, and he's not going to be choosing to go into that offlane like maybe I thought he would. Don't see where Destiny or Conqueror are going just yet. It looks as though they might just try lane up top. Have Zaturk in the mid lane and then offlane. It is pretty just standard. It's going to be Gigan. So we take a look at the other side. Pingu, he's going to take that Necrophos into the safe lane. We take a look at the off lane. It looks as though it's going to be a Pi Juggernaut there. Kyoku on the Lich and Ascendant. So they're going to go rolling tri lane in the off lane. And then 4-0, he's going to be mid. And of course, that is pretty standard. So it looks as though it's going to be tri lane against tri lane. Tri lane in the off lane for the side of Dunlap. And then Power of Friendship, they will go tri lane up top, but for right now, Konko has made his way over mid. Not pushed too far back. Don't think he's going to be going for the block, but he is coming over by Smacks. He's trying to get himself this bounty rune, and he's not going to be able to grab it as Pi does pick it up. So it's three bounty runes going the way of Dunlap, and I guess when all is said and done, it's an early lead. We'll have to watch these lanes settle. We take a look. Weaver, Ogre Magi, and possibly a Disruptor coming up top against what looks as though a Juggernaut and a Dazzle. And then coming over on the back end is a Lich. So, in terms of possibilities for kills, Smacks, he hits pretty hard early on. And if Pi gets caught out, maybe he spins a little bit too early. He could find himself going down. Of course, you might have yourselves a Shallow Grave early on, but for right now, it's just Poison Touch, and for Lich, it is the Sacrifice, so nothing too life-saving right now in the offlane. For the side of Dunlap and Smacks, Destiny, Conkle, maybe they can set something up, get an Ignite, as well as a Thunderstrike that'll do a bit of damage to the side of Dunlap. But once they get that Kinetic Field and the Fire Blast, they might have an opportunity at a couple of kills. Ascendant is going to throw that Poison Touch out there. And already, Conkle is going to have to eat that Tango. So, to see what's going on. Anna, aka Conkle, getting hit pretty hard again early on. This might send him all the way back to base. He's going to continue to have that Tango as well as the Clarity. But he's taking a lot of harass, and if he's not too careful, these supports can definitely find a kill on him with the Poison Touch, as well as a Frost Blast yet to come. So, that's set up to be an interesting lane. We take our look over mid. Zero, he's got himself 7-2, while Zaturk is 6-3, so about even for right now. And Zaturk, he's going to be on the disadvantage with the bear nearby, and learn something new every day. Bear can pick up the bounty rune. With the bear picking up the bounty rune, he's going to be right ported on back, and this is two people going for the last hits and denies, while Zaturk is just one man. So we take a look down low, a little bit of a bad camera work. Gigan, Conkle, and Destiny are all down here. Ping might have been in a little bit of trouble, but he's level 3. He should be alright. He's got himself that heal, as well as the Ghost Shroud, so no real fear for him, but this does just leave Smacks up top alone, so he's got to be careful here and don't want to get too far forward. But the rotations have already come out bottom, and now the Shrine is used by both Conkle and Gigan, and they'll be right back in a lane. So, game's pretty steady and even for right now. They've switched it up with Conkle and Gigan down low with Destiny. That's a tri-lane down low up against Pingu. He's got to be a little bit careful. If he goes too far out, Fire Blast could arrive, as well as a pit of Malice, but not skilled just yet, just the Firestorm. So I'll have to see how Power of Friendship do go up against this singular Necrophos. And he's 10-3, so he's not doing too poorly now up against the tri-lane. Take a look over mid. There's the Poison Touch. Just going to push Zaturk back, open up the last hits 4-0, and 0. He doesn't lead right now at 14. Now 15-2. He's now one in front of Zaturk, but it should be a bit of an easier spread when you've got two guys going for last hits, and the possibility to harass out Zaturk a little bit easier than most mid laners. So Destiny does disconnect from the game. We get a pause, and I guess we'll be back in a little bit. So we are ready to go once again. We're unpaused, and they're looking to go on smacks. Ascendant is coming over on that Dazzle. They do have Kyoku and Pi, but Pi's a little bit low. He's going to have to be careful if they want to go in on smacks. Got Ascendant just sitting here. He's got the Poison Touch available, as well as the Shadow Wave, so they could get the heal on Pi, which could burst smacks down a little bit. He's going to Shikuchi over towards his Sentry Ward. Might be in a little bit of trouble. There's the Poison Touch to slow him up, but they're not going to chase, as the Shikuchi is enough to break himself away from the side of Dunwap. So Firestorm going to rain onto Pingyu, but not in too much trouble. Has himself level 2 in the Death Pulse heal, so he's not too scared up against these two down low. Take a look over mid, Zero and Zaturk, still about even. Zaturk a little bit further ahead than Zero, and do take a look, they do spot this haste rune, and trying to think about what to do with it. So 5 minutes in, still no first blood. Both sides being pretty careful. Zaturk, he's going to have that salve canceled pretty quickly by Zero. We take a look up top. Smack still okay. There's quite a bit of sentry wards up here, but it's not helping them catch up with Smack, who's got that Shikuchi and high movement speed with it. So finally making their way over with the smoke is Kyoku and Ascendant, looking for the first blood on Zaturk. They're going to make their way along, long way around this Roche pit, and Zaturk, he's pretty far back towards tower, so if the two on Dunlap are going to want to go after this, they're going to have to wait until he moves forward. And there's the creep wave starting to push forward. Zaturk, though, sitting a bit back. They might want to go in. Now he's towards the river. There's the ping, but nobody coming over just yet, and there's the smoke broken. Kyoku has been spotted, but Zaturk, he still just sits here. They're trying to find something. There's the Poison Touch as well as the Frost Blast. He's feared up, but going to be able to ghost walk right on out. So they go under tower. They've got two rotating, and they don't find anything with it. Meanwhile, down low, Giggins looking for Pingyu. He's going to spot him out with Destiny, but Pingyu, he's made some juking moves. He's now under ward vision. There's the Ignite, going to slow him down just a little bit. The TP's coming in. The Sunstrike is going to land, and that is first blood for Zaturk. Kanko might be in a little bit of damage. He's getting hit with that spin from Pi, so it is a return kill. Blade Fury doing enough, and now Ascendant and Kyoku are here. They're going to slow down Gigan with the Frost Blast as well as the Poison Touch. One more hit, and Pi's got himself a double kill. So first blood goes the way of Zaturk, but Pi rotates over and gets himself two. So maybe not the way Power of Friendship would like that to go. They do grab themselves first blood for their mid laner, Zaturk. Gonna give him the leg up on Zero, but you give two kills away to a Juggernaut, and I don't think you're gonna be too happy about that. So another Poison Touch, Gigan. He's taking a lot of damage right now. Fire Blast comes over. Omni Slash comes on through from Pi, and Gigan's dead again. It's a third kill for Pi, and he's now 3-0-0, or 2-0-1, I should say, as his team now leads 3-1. We take this over towards the net worth about 8 minutes in. We take a look at our first time net worth graph, and it's only 750 in favor of Dunlap. Nothing too crazy. Meanwhile, mids, the Turks pretty low. They are going to get the glimpse back on zero with the Thunderstrike, but it's not going to be enough to find themselves a kill. So now Smack's up against Pingu with this Necro. It's an interesting lane for the side of Power Friendship. Smack's, he's level 6, so he did have to use that time lapse, and that's going to be on cooldown for 45 seconds. And just by looking at the map, looking at where everybody's at, you've got the Juggernaut and the Lone Druid in the top 3 for the side of net worth. It's not looking too great for Power Friendship, but the longer they can extend this game, get their Invoker some farm and Weaver as well, they might be okay to take on this Juggernaut, Necro, and Lone Druid core combo. So Shikuchi forward, just going to get a little bit of damage out on Pingu, but there is the Death Pulse. We'll push back Smacks once again. You've got Zero, Ascendant, and Kyoku. All mid looking for this tower. There is the Deafening Blast. It is going to hit on Zero, but not too long of a duration. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower. Take a look down low. Gigan again in a little bit of trouble. There's the Poison Touch. He's going to try and Dark Rift out. Does he have enough time? 2-1, and he's got it. So they don't find the kill, and just about at that 10-minute mark, it's 3-1 in favor of Dunlap. No real aggression coming out from either side. So two come over, smoked up, Destiny and Conkle. Out on this Disruptor and Ogre Magi, but backing off already is this Necrophos, and that's it. Smoke gank averted. Dunlap, they like this. They put on the early pressure onto Power Friendship. They're farming up at a pretty solid rate. No need to fight, no need to get some kills. You want those first couple of items. But now coming over is Gingu Destiny as well as Smacks. They are going to look for this Sunstrike. It's going to land on Pingu, but he's going to use that Reaper Scythe. Not enough. There's the time lapse. And Conkle will find himself the kill on Pingu. So the kill goes the way of Power of Friendship. They'll be alright with that. They take out the core of the Necrophos, the poorest of the cores. But still a core nonetheless on the side of Dunlap. So Dunlap, they're trying to siege this tier 1 down low. It's taking quite some time, and Gigan's the only one here defending. He's going to use that Firestorm, try and burst down this Creep Wave, but Pi's coming in. There's the Omnislash, goes back into the Creep Wave just a bit. And they are trying to get this kill on Gigan with the Blade Fury. Should be easy, and he will find it. That's now a killing spree for Pi. Coming over is a Turk, trying to make something happen. There's the Cold Snap, trying to slow down Pi. Lead him into the Sunstrike, but not going to have it. There's the Shikuchi by Smacks, and they will find a kill. Meanwhile, back towards tower, Destiny as well as Konko are pretty low. They are going to get that glimpse back. No teleport for Kyoku here with the Shikuchi again is Smacks, and the double hit is enough for the kill, followed up by Destiny. So they are going to shrine up, and up top, Gigan has teleported over. Here's the TP coming in for the Ogre Magi Destiny. Pingu still just trying to farm. Maybe they can find something on the side of Power of Friendship, but they don't know that Zero's nearby. Zero looking to come around. Destiny's a tanky hero, going to be a hard sell. I'm trying to get this kill. He does spot out Destiny. They're looking for something, not going to find it. Now they know Zero's there. He's trying to attack these creeps, TPing in. There's nobody, actually. Dire's top tower is under attack. So Perseverance finished for this Weaver, not going to elect to go for the Desolator afterwards. Looks as though he's going to go for that Lincoln Sphere. There's the Kinetic Field, going to slow down Kyoku for just a bit. The Thunderstrike follows it up as well as the Ignite. The Fire Blast hits, looking for the Sunstrike. It's going to be on the money, and there is the Shallow Grave by Ascendant, but he has nothing to save himself. Smacks is going to find himself the first kill. Lich will die as well. And now Smacks trying to fight Zero. There's the Static Storm onto the Necrophos. Pingu might be in a little bit of trouble. He'll fall as well. And three are dead on the side of Dunlap. Meanwhile, Pi takes a bottom tier 1, but in the grand scheme of things, that's a 1400 net worth swing in favor of Power of Friendship. Max finding himself a couple of kills, just about level 11, still looking for this Lincoln Sphere early on, about 900 gold away from the ulti orb, and then another 1,000 from the recipe, and they'll look to take their first tower of the game. So coming over is Pingu, maybe trying to find something. There's the Pit of Malice. Max is going to Shikuchi out, but he's been dusted up. They're going to chase on forward on the side of Dunlap, but it doesn't look as though they're going to catch up to the side of Power of Friendship on either Gigan or Smacks. So Zero backing off. Maybe they can find something on the side of Power of Friendship. They do spot Zero, and there's the Swarm coming in with the Ignite. Zero's going to be slowed down. The Swarm doing a lot of damage. Going to fear up Smacks and save his own life. Rooted up is Destiny. I'll take a bit of chip damage from Zero and take a look over at Kyoku up top. Gigan one shot away from falling, and Ascendant will be granted that last hit. Sunstrike comes in, Shallow Grave's there anyway, and it's going to be off the money. So Zeturk, he's got himself a Yule's, maybe going to go for an Ags next. He's not far behind on this Juggernaut, who's got himself a Yasha, looking for the Mantis style early. We'll have to see what Pi can do with this Juggernaut at top net worth 500 gold up in front of this Invoker. And Zero's after the Invoker. He's got himself about 6200 net worth, looking for the Maelstrom Mjolnir combo. And by combo, I mean it's one item. You combine it, and you get yourself a Mjolnir. Zero, he's level 12, he's already hitting for 127, or 117, excuse me, math is not my strong suit. He's got the Dragonlance, and he's close on this Maelstrom. He's level 12, so he's got himself already 175 attack range from that level 10 skill. And he'll be looking for that 55 damage at level 15. We take a look over mid, and using that Ghostwalk is Zeturk. The rotations come out from Gigan and Destiny. Kyoku, Ascendant, and Pingu are all mid looking for a tier 2. There's the Pit of Malice. And the Blade Fury gonna have Pi moving back. There's 4 here for Dunlap. They're gonna glimpse back Pi. He's back in the Pit of Malice. There's the stun with the Chaos Meteor. Pi getting very low, but he's gonna use that Omni Slash to avoid some damage. And now he's into that Static Storm. Pi gonna be Shallow Graved, and he'll be alright. Meanwhile, off camera, he's gonna be Smacks getting himself a kill. He's looking for more. He's gonna grab himself a second on the Dazzle, and then they'll be able to chase down the side of Dunlap. They got no Shallow Grave. And now no Healing Ward to Smacks. He's using the Shikuchi to try and catch up to Pi. There's the Pit of Malice on too. They're still trying to fight Dunlap as Zero and Pingu are here. Smacks is going to give up on the dream of killing that Juggernaut, looking for Pingu and Zero. Zeturk man fighting on Zero and might be in a little bit of trouble. He's going to use himself up, stop fighting in front of this lone druid. And with that, and that kill on to Zero, they will Dark Rift out. So Power Friendship, they grab the first to 10 kills, and we take a look down low. Pi might be in a little bit of trouble again. There's the Tornado coming out with the Sunstrike. It's going to land the Swarm. One more shot and a kill. And split between Smacks and Zeturk. So you've got Conkle, you've got Destiny. They're smoked up just in case anybody was on the back end, but it was just Pi. And that kill was easy as Pi. Sorry. Terrible. So Lincoln's gets picked up for Smacks. He's getting himself a wand as well. be looking for this Desso.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Radiant structures are fortified.
So Pingu, he's farming all right.
Radiant's bottom tower.
Going for the Guardian Greaves and then the Blink, so
Radiant's bottom tower.
More of a position 3 high farm support. Like a Darkseer. Get yourself those Guardian Greaves and a Blink. Try to be effective with that Reaper Scythe, and that's pretty much it. So coming over with the smoke is Dunlap. They're trying to make a move onto the side of Power Friendship. They might have overstayed their welcome. Coming over through the side is Pi and Smacks. He's Shikuchi'd up, and now he's shown himself in the middle of the side of Dunlap, but the Lincoln's there to save him. Gigan will just TP out, and the five-man smoke from Dunlap, they do nothing with it. So we take a look at the net worth graph. About 2,000 in favor of Power of Friendship. They've got Zaturk farming pretty well. He's got himself the Boots of Travel Ags next, and then Smacks. He actually elects not to go for the Desolator. He's going to be going, for the Maelstrom. Omnislash comes out. It's immediately going to go on to Conko and get himself a kill, but Pinamalus stops Pi in his tracks. Smacks should be okay. He's got the time lapse regardless. And now 4 are mid for the side of Dunlap, and they deny this tower as well. So Cold Snap onto the bear. They're looking for 300 gold. They'll take it. Zaturk grabs it, and even closer to that axe. With that axe, it should be a big power spike for the side of Power Friendship. Look over at these pings. No smoke coming over, but 3 cores farming in the same spot. So it looks as though Gigan, he'll be going for the Guardian Greaves as well. 5R bottom for this side of Dunlap. Power Friendship, they're trying to push mid. Push towards a tier 2 while on the back end. Dunlap, they're looking for a tier 2 down low. Deafening Blast comes out. Boy, if you're going to avoid that for Pi, Pit of Malice is in front of this tower, but nobody walking into it on the side of Dunlap. And now Dunlap will just retreat, but coming over with the TP is Smacks. There's the Static Storm out on 2. They might be in a little bit of trouble, though, which is going to be the first to fall. Pi might be now stuck in between the side of Power of Friendship as he gets hit by that Fire Blast. Pingu trying to do something with that heal. There's the Reaper Scythe, but that is all too early. Pitamalus comes out on 3 with the Chaos Meteor. Ascendant's going to have to use that Shallow Grave on just himself to TP out. He's going to be stunned up, so he's not even going to be able to retreat. He'll fall. That's 2 dead on the side of Dunlap. Keegan trying to do something. Smacks is going to eat that Omni Slash. The Turk going to find himself another kill. They're looking for 2 on the side of Dunlap. They do grab it, but the Sunstrike strikes down on Lone Druid. And they will grab a 3rd. Now in a bit of trouble is Pingu. There's the EMP with the Yules. And Pingu trying Ghost Shroud and find an escape. But with the Fire Blast coming in from Destiny, he will fall. So 5. That was a full team wipe. Just the low respawn times are already back up. Power of Friendship, they lose 2. On the side of Dunlap, they lose 5. And a 1600 net worth change, and we take a look at the net worth graph now. 4000 in favor of Power of Friendship. So with that fight, it's gonna be 200 gold away from an Ags, and Dunlap, they were in a bit of trouble in that fight. It was a bit sloppy from the side of Power of Friendship, and now they've got the Ags coming out in just a moment for Zaturk. He'll be that much stronger. And then 4 Smacks still thinking about either this Maelstrom or a Desolator. Hasn't bought anything just yet. He might want to buy completely out on a Maelstrom if he's going to go for it.
A gift from the Tempest of
Battle. Booker has a 3,000 net worth advantage over this Juggernaut, who's got himself the Manta. He'll be going for Maelstrom as well, but Helm and Manta, it's all right, but it's really not enough to fight up against this Power Friendship squad. So everybody just sitting back, farming up. We take a look over top. Zaturk continuing to farm, now has that Ags. He'll be looking for a Lincoln Sphere of his own. Not a bad pickup. And here come the TPs into Shrine. They just about feel that Dunlap's going for Roche's. This is something they desperately need. There's the Pit of Malice. Pi might be in a bit of trouble. Roche doing a lot of help for the side of Power Friendship. There comes the Chain Frost. It'll bounce three times, but really not too much. And now they've expended quite a bit on the side of Dunlap. And now they're trying to run away. There's the Kinetic Field. Ascendant and Pinger are going to be locked up, but still nobody dead just yet. Smacks is going to try and take care of Ascendant. Ascendant does get away, but there's the Shikuchi. And now following suit is Pingu as he falls as well. There is the Blade Fury from Pi. He'll try to TP out and will successfully do so. So two die on the side of Dunlap, but this could be an easy Roche for Power Friendship now that the Necro is down. So Tornado, that is going to hit on the Lich with the Sunstrike. Zaturk making easy work of Kyoku on this Lich up top. That's disgusting. With that kill, Power Friendship, they'll push mid. They put a Pin of Malice down to make some space so nobody on the side of Dunlap comes after them. They'll take a look up top and they'll go for a tier 2, but hopefully they read the patch notes. Tier 2s do not grant you Shrine. So Smack, Zaturk, Gigan, Destiny, they're all up top right now. There's the Pit of Malice still spacing out the side of Dunlap. Rooted up again is Pingu. He's already used that Ghost Shroud. There's the Fire Blast. They're not going to be able to save this Tier 3 up top. Sunstrike is thrown. Going to be off the mark. Here comes the Blade Fury from Pi. There's the Static Storm with the Tornado. Going to line it all up. Here comes a Chaos Meteor. And down goes the Dazzle. So already one dead. The Omni Slash comes through in a desperate play, but Pingu already dead. There's the Deafening Blast. Manta style not doing anything about it. Smax is going to grab himself a couple of kills. He's got a double kill. There is the Reaper Scythe on the Invoker, however, and he'll be dead for 100 seconds. So with that, Power Friendship, they got to back out. That is 1,200 gold going the way of Dunlap and Pingu. And then gated by quite a bit from that buyback, but it's 100 seconds without an Invoker on the side of Power Friendship. They've taken a tier 3. They'll go after this Shrine. They'll get it. And now they've smoked up. Maybe Dunlap are not expecting this. And Pingu, who's already bought back, but he's backed off enough just to be out of the reach of Power Friendship. Had he died again, that could have just been game. So Diffusal Blade next for Smax. There it is. Still no Deso, and he's gotten rid of that Blightstone, so it won't be there. So So Aegis is reclaimed in 2 minutes. They might want to make another move beforehand, but they are waiting for this invoker. He's dead for still 15 more seconds. Trying to push his pie with these illusions, but Smacks cleans up very well, and now top two of the net worth are the Invoker and Weaver, respectively. Down low, Smacks, he's going to show himself in this bottom lane. Pingu hiding in the trees. Not going to see a scan come out. Actually up top, Zaturk's going to be fighting Pi. Going to land that Sunstrike back off. He'll be okay. There's the Blade Fury from Juggernaut just to get him out for sure. And this is four down low inside of Power Friendship. Smoking up, going across. Looking for a fight with Dunlap. Pingu, he's still bottom. And he does have a TP if they do choose to come over. So Bear shows himself. Ascendant going to be spotted. There's the Pit of Malice on two. Firestorm as well. There's the Swarm. Ascendant already dead. They're looking for more. There's the Chain Frost back, bouncing back and forth. And now Zero as well as this Jugger here. Conkling going to use that Glimmer Cape to get out. Meanwhile, Smacks is on a godlike streak. And they've lost none on the side of Power of Friendship. They're looking to dive this tower. There's the Tornado on two. And with that Chaos Meteor as well as the Pit of Malice, Smacks trying to do easy work of the side of Dunlap. Smacks gets another. That's three dead on the side of Dunlap with the buyback coming out from Pi. And nobody dead on the side of Power of Friendship. They'll just back off. So they back off. They'll take this other shrine for free. And the rich get richer in this game, and it is 15,000 net worth lead for Power of Friendship. So Winkins is finished. Looking for this last tier 2, should feel safe about pushing, not really much stopping them in terms of teamfight on the side of Dunlap. They're up 15,000 net worth as well, as long as they play it pretty well. They should be alright on the side of Power Friendship, be able to finish off this game. So just sitting back a bit. Not really looking to force the issue on the side of Power Friendship for the time being. We take a look up top. Pingu. He's got to watch out. The ward gets taken out by the Weaver. Not finding anything else, but Power Friendship, they're sitting a bit further back than I thought they might. Slowly pushing out these waves. The Juggernaut trying to push him right on back, doing what he can. He's going for a Basher next as he's picked up this Maelstrom. That helps his illusions push these waves back and make it a little bit harder for Power of Friendship to really come in. Not too certain why they want to continue to farm on the side of Power Friendship. They're up about 20,000 net worth. Going for the Bloodthorn next is this Weaver Smacks, and see if they're just waiting for Roche. They're just looking to farm. Roche Aegis wouldn't be too bad. They don't want this invoker dead for another minute. Smax, he's gonna push this mid lane back towards the side of Dunlap. We're pretty much trapped in their base. Not really much in terms of damage and teamfight that can safely let them out. They get caught up in a fight with Power of Friendship. It's going to be a hard one to win. So Roche back up in about 5 seconds. Have to see if Power Friendship want to go for it, or if they're just going to continue to farm here. Again, Pingu stuck in these trees on the side as Smax just continues to farm away. So they take a look over. There's a double damage right by the Roche pit, and Roche ready to be taken. It is going to be Smax to pick up the double damage and continue to work here. They look for the second Roche of the game. So now Aegis is on this Weaver once again. It's hard to kill him once, let alone two times, and Zeturk will TP up top to try to push his top wave out. Mid is pushed in by Smax, and now he'll head towards these creep waves over on the side just to get even more farm. Getting really close to this Bloodthorn. Can never have enough farm. So Tornado comes out with the Sunstrike. There's the Blade Fury from Pi. Pit of Malice is there to make some space. Pingu blinks in, trying to heal up his teammates, and nothing happening just yet with this Pit of Malice on the ground. They're trying to wait that out. Here comes the Tornado again with the EMP, and Lich gonna be in a little bit of trouble. Just gonna avoid it. There's the kinetic field only hitting on the bear. Now Pi's trying to come in with that Blade Fury, doing a lot of damage. He'll already time-lapse, and now the Static Storm and Firestorm coming out onto the side of Dunlap. Kyoku's going to be the first victim to fall. Pi is going to get hit by that Shallow Grave. That'll keep him alive for a little bit longer. Buyback is here from the Lich. Meanwhile, they've lost this top set of racks. Deafening Blast comes out on the Lone Druid. They can't really do much about it. Pin of Malice, as well as the Tornado, hits on a bunch on the side of Dunlap. There's the Reaper Scythe. Not going to be enough to bring down Gigan, as they've already lost two. And Pingu, just like that, will call GG. Or not. They lost two. Another Tornado hits on zero. Zeturk just gonna try and man fight him. Fireblast comes out as well as the Ignite. Smack's gonna join in the fray, and that's five dead. Buyback from the Lone Druid. Zero doesn't want to give back. Pi buys back as well. And backing off is the Power of Friendship. Power Friendship, I mean, they got the GG call, but doesn't look as though the game is over. Bloodthorn comes out for the Weaver. Smax very rich at 21,000 net worth, as well as this Invoker at 25,000. He's got himself that Octarine Core. Trying to farm up and sustain. Is Dunlap, but they're in a little bit of trouble. They've lost this top set of racks. That's about it, though. In terms of base getting destroyed. Bottling up this double damage is going to be Smacks. That could be what they need to just go on in on the side of Dunlap. Coming over is Smacks, and he's going to Shikuchi over into the smoke of Dunlap. He is mid. They got to make a move if they're Dunlap to try and bring down Smacks, who's now spotted out the side of Dunlap. Bear is brought back. There's the swarm. They're trying to get something done. Kyoku immediately going to die. The Reaper Scythe hits, but not enough. So he's going to be able to time-lapse, and he'll be back to full health. And backing off is the side of Dunlap. Here comes a tornado. It'll hit a bear. And now in a bit of trouble is Pi. He's going to Omni-Slash, try and get himself away, and it goes on to Zaturk. A couple others. There's the Deafening Blast. Will finish him off is Conko. The bear in a bit of trouble. He's under Pit of Malice. Zero trying to hit from the high ground. But now Zaturk is here, and Zaturk wants blood. He's going to throw that Sunstrike out. Not going to be there, but Gigan does get himself the kill. Pingu going to walk right into that Pit of Malice. He'll be silenced up. He'll fall as well. Four dead on the side of Dunlap. Make it five. As the GG is called, and this time it's for real. So game one goes the way of Power of Friendship, 39 minutes, 41 seconds in this best of two. They have a 1-0 lead. We'll have to see if Dunlap can turn it around. Power of Friendship, a pretty dominant win. We'll be back with game two in just a moment.